Hello everyone, Lytra Storm here, and today we are pushing forward with part 3 of What If Vegeta Rebelled Early. You guys have been asking for it for a while, and I think it's long overdue, so I'm gonna give it to you now. But before we begin, make sure you join my Discord server and follow me on Twitter. Links in the description, as always. In part 2, I explained that Raditz went to Earth and trained with Goku for the 8 months until the Saiyans arrive. However, in part 2, I explained that the Elite Warrior shut down every pod in Frieza's ship. And I also said that Raditz collected the Dragon Balls for Bulma. However, I'm going to slightly change both of these things. The Elite Warrior still tells Vegeta and Nappa after being interrogated that Raditz has gone to Earth, but he doesn't shut down the pods. We're also retconning Nappa's power level to 9,000 after the 2 Zenkais, because I think it fits better this way, and it's more logical. Anyway, instead, when Raditz collects the Dragon Balls, he wishes to send Vegeta and Nappa back, so it still takes 8 months for them to get there. Anyway, Raditz formed a relationship with Mai, and when the Saiyans arrive, they lose to Raditz and the Sea Fighters, who don't face any deaths. Frieza heard the discussion of the Dragon Balls and Namekians and begins to travel to Namek. The Saiyans leave Earth as well, and Kami tells the Z Fighters that they need to protect his home planet of Namek, as he doesn't want to see it fall for no reason to the Saiyans. Bulma fixes up Kami's ship while all the Z Fighters train together. However, during this time, Raditz does not train, and instead, he goes back to Mai, and they plan a wedding before everyone leaves. The Z Fighters halt their training and go to the wedding before the humans leave on Kami's ship. Piccolo and Goku stay behind to go in the gravity ship with Raditz eventually, once it's built. And eventually, they leave as well, at the same time Goku did in canon. After they leave, Mai finds out she's pregnant, making Raditz the father-to-be. Let me know what you guys think this half-Saiyan should be. Male or female? And what should their name be? Ideas for their personality? Comment your ideas. Anyway, I have all the power levels of the humans, Goku, and Piccolo after their regular training with each other, and Raditz's power level after his Zenkai on screen, so be sure you're watching the video or you'll miss them. Now we're skipping over to Vegeta and Nappa, who've arrived at Frieza's ship to have personal talk with him. Frieza looks at the two Saiyans.
Well, well, you really thought you could play me for a fool. One mission, you're equal to Kui, and two later, you're stronger than Zarbon. That's just absurd. At first, I thought you just had dumb luck. But now I see. I suspect going to Earth made you stronger too. 40,000, I know what I'm going to do. I'll give you a final chance to show your loyalty to the Frieza Force. We're heading to Namek as we speak. Nappa, Kui will be assisting you. And Dodoria and Zarbon will both assist you, Vegeta. Oh, and one more thing. If you try anything, I will not hesitate to call the Ginyu Force to handle you themselves. Goodbye now, monkeys.
The two then leave, and Frieza tells Zarbon from now on he has to stay in his true form, as if he gets caught off guard, Vegeta will be able to dispose of him easily. Zarbon, Dodoria, and Kui then leave as well. The Z Fighters arrive on Namek in Kami's ship, and when they do, they see Dodoria attacking in the Namekian village. They also see Zarbon keeping watch to make sure Vegeta doesn't try anything. They see Dende and Mori being the last survivors, and Mori destroys all the scouters in the area, causing his death. They plan to save Dende, and do so by having Yamcha rush in and grab him, flying off with Chaozu and Yajirobe while Tenshinhan and Krillin both use a solar flare to blind Zarbon, Dodoria, and Vegeta. The solar flare blinds the first two, but Vegeta, having fought the Z Fighters on Earth, knew of this technique and prepared for it by covering his eyes. Zarbon and Dodoria rush after him, but Vegeta is too fast for them, having ditched his scouter and now just sensing for Nappa, since he learned that ability on Earth. He plans to 2-on-3 Frieza's forces, as it'll help them massively if they work together. Nappa senses Vegeta coming toward him on his scouter, crushing it before launching himself at Kui. Kui dodges his attacks and parries with a blast aimed to his head. He fires a blast and Nappa is nowhere to be seen. "I must have atomized him," he said, before realizing his scouter was missing as well. His arm then snapped from behind, as Nappa had avoided the attack thanks to Vegeta swinging by. Nappa and a now-injured Kui go at it evenly, but since Nappa can sense energy, he has a pretty distinct advantage, and he eventually wins over time. Vegeta continues to take on Zarbon and Dodoria at once, and they're keeping up well, dealing pretty good damage. However, Vegeta is separating them so he can pick them off one at a time. Vegeta blasts Dodoria, incapacitating him enough for him to rush behind and grab him by the arms, with only one hand, pointing the other at Zarbon.
So, is there any info you're willing to give up over your life?
Dodoria quickly beams up, yelling that Frieza was the one who destroyed Vegeta's home planet, and that he never liked Frieza, and would be happy to help him defeat him. He then looks over to Zarbon, asking him if he'd join Vegeta as well, but Zarbon just smirks, saying that, like him, Frieza is hiding a true form as well. And that, even if he wanted to help Vegeta, which he doesn't, they would all die. Dodoria then repeats his offer to Vegeta, and Vegeta smirks.
Sorry, but I've already got a partner,
he says before tossing Dodoria into the air, with Zarbon taking this moment to rush at him, but he blasts Zarbon in the chest. And as Dodoria is flying through the air, he's blasted by Nappa, who had just arrived. This blast kills the off-guard coward, leaving the two Saiyans seemingly alone. That is until Zarbon gets back up and blasts Nappa with his remaining strength before getting one-shotted by Vegeta. This blast damages Nappa a lot, so Vegeta lifts him over his shoulder, carrying him onto Frieza's ship. He tells Apool that Nappa was nearly killed in one of their fights with the Namekian warriors. Apool starts the healing tank up once Vegeta gets Nappa into it, and the prince thanks him before flying off to collect the Dragon Balls. Before I say anything else, I want to point out that Frieza did call in the Ginyu Force not only for scouters, but to deal with Vegeta, Nappa, the Earthlings, and finish off the Namekians, as all of this conflict was starting to annoy him. Vegeta collects the same balls as in canon, but when he goes to take them from the Z Fighters, replacing Gohan are Yajirobe and Chaozu, who, due to them being the weakest, are paired with each other while the others go solo. Now obviously Yajirobe and Chaozu are nothing to this Vegeta, and are swiftly beaten without much hesitation. And Vegeta remarks saying that he wants to kill the fat one for slicing off his tail and costing him the battle on Earth. He doesn't have time to waste, and with immortality, he can deal with these squabbles easily. Also, due to training more and getting more in shape, Yajirobe is only slightly chubby. This isn't really that important, but I thought I'd point it out. Vegeta escapes with the ball in hand, and Yajirobe and Chaozu fly off to the rest of the group who have gathered at Guru's house.
After everyone gathers at Guru's house, they all get their potentials unlocked, and their power level skyrockets to a low of 8,000 and a high of 26,000. As I said before, check the screen to see who is who. Anyway, Vegeta, after hiding the Dragon Balls, goes back to his ship to grab Nappa, now healed from his injuries as it wasn't very severe, leaving Nappa's power level now at 21,000. If you want an explanation for this, it's basically that I believe the theory that Saiyans get Zenkai boosts to boost themselves above their closest threats. And Nappa's closest threat at the time was Kui, who was at 18,000. Anyway, Vegeta and Nappa carry the Dragon Balls, but the Ginyus arrive, forcing them to join up with the Z Fighters. Ginyu takes the balls and leaves, leaving a 4-on-7 matchup. The Ginyu Force decide to have a few 2-on-1 battles, leaving two to fight 1-on-1. The groups agree to this, as Vegeta and Nappa are definitely prideful in their abilities as Saiyans, and the humans are shown to have some pride as well, so defeating them without just rushing in and trying to outnumber them makes most sense for them. Also, it might just be a better bet overall, since then the Ginyus can't help each other. So this might seem reckless, but there is logic behind it. So here are the matchups. Goldo versus Chaozu and Yajirobe, Krillin and Yamcha versus Jace, Tenshinhan and Nappa versus Birder, and Vegeta versus Raccoon. The three weakest faced off first, and Goldo seemingly outdoes them well, dodging Yajirobe's sword swings using the time stop, but eventually when he takes a breath, Yajirobe swings at him, and before he can react, Chaozu freezes him with telekinesis, allowing for Yajirobe to slice his head off. The Ginyus applaud for their victory, and Jace prepares to take on the Turtle Students. Krillin and Yamcha have years of experience fighting and training together, so taking on a foe more powerful than them isn't as big of a struggle as it would be for two people who don't have teamwork skills. However, that doesn't mean they win easily. Their power levels are still a lot lower than Jace's, so he pretty much bodies them for the majority of the fight. However, being a part of the Ginyu Force, he's very cocky. Jace has the clear advantage, but Krillin and Yamcha's energies are rising due to having their potentials unlocked. On top of this, they're forming a plan as the fight progresses. Due to their teamwork, they form a plan while fighting and eventually come up with something. Krillin rushes at Jace but pulls back, using a solar flare to blind him while Yamcha charges up a spirit barges up, a scatter attack. Once Jace is unblinded, he gets surrounded by Krillin's newly charged scatter blast, and Yamcha uses the spirit ball to slam him into the blast over and over, damaging Jace quite a bit.
When Jace is released, Yamcha takes him on, and since he's increased while Jace has decreased from taking damage, they fight about evenly, with the red magma having the edge. However, that's when Krillin unleashes a destructive disc, nearly slicing him in half, but he barely dodges, allowing for Yamcha to hit him with a Wolf Fang fist that launches him into a mountain. This hit drains Yamcha of nearly all of his energy, but Jace is knocked out because of it, giving the win to the Z Fighters. The next match is Tenshinhan and Nappa versus Birder. Unlike the last matchups, these guys have no sense of teamwork. In fact, Tenshinhan hates Nappa for threatening Earth, and Nappa dislikes Tenshinhan because he thinks he's a weak Earthling. However, here it is apparent that Nappa is actually weaker than him, which just makes Nappa even angrier. The fight begins with everyone spread apart and rushing in at each other. Tenshinhan and Nappa are both attacking Birder, yes, but none of their attacks can do anything because A, Birder is stronger and faster than them, and B, they keep on bumbling over each other with every attack. Birder knocks them both back, saying that their teamwork isn't even comparable to that of the Ginyus, and that he'll easily beat them all if they continue like this. Tenshinhan gets up, yelling to Nappa that they need to work together or they'll lose, but Nappa isn't having any of it. He charges at Birder, but is easily dodged and hit several times before he could even try to react. This results in Nappa being thrown back repeatedly, with Tenshinhan trying to attack afterwards so that they won't get in each other's way, but he doesn't do much of a better job despite gaining strength over time. Tenshinhan yells to Nappa that they can't win like this before getting kicked by Birder. Nappa is angry at this attempt, but Tenshinhan shows that he's being serious by continually taking on Birder alone while Nappa recovers. Eventually, the brute says to hell with it and charges in, asking what he needs him to do. The Three-Eyed Warrior says that he just needs to stall, before jumping backward to let Birder and Nappa fight. Birder, after effortlessly beating down the Saiyan, realizes what's happening, and jumps at Tenshinhan, but Nappa hops in the way to stop him, just for a little longer, by surprise kicking him. Birder gets angry and grabs Nappa, swinging him around in the tornado that he created with his own speed, and launches him into a mountain, near death. By that point, Tenshinhan has completed his attack, launching a fully powered tri-beam at Birder, dealing massive damage to put him near death as well. Everyone was injured and weakened, but Tenshinhan could at least still stand, whereas the other two could not. Finally, we get to the last match, the equal Raccoon and Vegeta facing off. As I just said, they go at it roughly evenly, although Vegeta has the advantage of being able to sense energy. So because he has the slight advantage and they're equal, Vegeta is winning the fight over time, since he realizes he can use this to his advantage. In the end though, they both end up bloodied and injured, Vegeta slightly less so, and Raccoon tries to finish it, while he can, with an eraser gun. But he's stopped, from a one-shot, from none other than Goku. Everyone is shocked to see him, and Piccolo begins passing out senzu beans to Vegeta, Nappa, and Tenshinhan, since they're the most injured. The others have already recovered by just sitting there and watching the fight. Raditz then shows up as well, and now it's time for me to give you their power levels. So Raditz's maximum gravity level would make him have to train in higher gravity, but Piccolo and Goku can't reach that level yet, resulting in Raditz having to go down to their level, eventually leading them all to 100 times gravity. So we'll balance out Raditz starting with more intense training, and also training with them on their gravity levels by giving him the same 9 times boost Goku got in canon. However, we'll give Goku an 18 times boost to double that, since he has 2 strong training partners, and we'll give Piccolo a 20 times, since he'll be increasing the most as he starts out the weakest of them. This makes Raditz go from 24,000 to 216,000, Goku from 10,000 to 180,000, and Piccolo from 7,000 to 140,000. Also, remember that Goku never went to King Kai, so no Kaioken or Spirit Bomb to rely on in this arc. Anyway, the three of them arriving, and the Ginyu Force's power levels depleting, result in Ginyu arriving, ready to snatch Raditz's body. Oh yeah. And with the Zenkai's, Vegeta has reached 320,000 and Nappa 168,000. Upon realizing this, he actually wants Vegeta's body more so. However, with all these power levels higher than his, Ginyu is just getting beaten down pretty easily by the group. Just when he's about to die, Jace surprises everyone, jumping up and kicking Nappa away. This shocks Vegeta, as he forgot he was alive, before blasting him into nothingness. This gave Ginyu the chance to prepare his body change technique, but Goku had rushed in to take it for him, as Vegeta was too powerful an ally to give to Frieza's side. Goku charges toward Vegeta, getting taken by the blast. This puts Ginyu's power level at 46,000, as Goku is double what he was in the main timeline, so now Ginyu in his body is double what he was. Ginyu realizes he's not in the body he wants, but that Goku's power was still above his own. However, he quickly gets beaten down by everyone even more so, realizing that he did not get the full power. He tries to get Raditz's body this time, allowing for Goku to rush back in to get his body back before Piccolo and Raditz kill the damaged Ginyu together. At that point, Vegeta and Nappa have already left the field, but they decide to come back due to their respect for the Z Fighters. Vegeta takes Goku to a healing tank, while Nappa gives Krillin, Yamcha, and Yajirobe armor, as Piccolo, Tenshin, and Chiaotzu are prideful in themselves, so they choose not to wear it. Vegeta doesn't take a nap in this timeline. Instead, they all decide to wait out Frieza until they think the time is right. And that is where we'll leave this part. What did you guys think of Part 3? How will the Z Fighters fare against Frieza now that they have more allies? Will Vegeta and Nappa permanently join them? I guess you'll just have to wait for the next part. If this vid can hit 4,000 views, I'll start putting Part 4 into production. So please, 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 share it with your friends. Oh yeah, and one more thing. The stick animation that you saw in this video about Birder versus Nappa and Tenshinhan was made by my friend, Futuristic. I'll link his YouTube channel in the description below. Make sure you go subscribe to him, as he's uploaded several stick figure battles. But as always, like the video if you enjoyed, tell me what you think will happen next, comment your requests of future videos, and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.